As a mammal paleobiologist, what we really hope to find in the field and in museum collections are teeth. And this is because teeth are the windows into the biology of a mammal. They give us information on what they ate, how they lived, and even the environments in which they lived. Teeth are how mammals catch, cut up, and chew their food. And the shape of those teeth determines how well an animal can exploit different types of food. This is the tooth of a hyena, for example. You can see that it closely resembles the blades of a pair of scissors. These teeth are perfect for slicing meat off of other animals. Bears have evolved more generalized teeth. These teeth act more like a mortar and pestle and would have been much better for processing foods like berries, fish, or other types of plants. What about this animal? What do you think Smilodon was eating? Smilodon has sharp, blade-like teeth. These are called the carnassial teeth, and they were used to cut through the flesh of other mammals. The big ones at the front may have had two purposes. They may have been used for sexual display and for catching their prey. So what else can we learn from teeth? It turns out that you are what you eat is pretty much true. When animals, like humans, eat food, the materials from those foods are used to build your muscles, your teeth, and your bones. And we can use the chemical signatures in your tissues to tell what you've been eating. If I took a piece of your tooth right now, I would be able to tell where you grew up and what type of water you were drinking when you grew those teeth. And we can use these same principles to go back into the fossil record and understand what fossil mammals like Smilodon were eating and drinking 10,000 years ago. Thank you.